They're probably the hottest team in the NHL right now. And no, I'm not talking about the New York Islanders or the Dallas Stars. We're talking today about a team that actually isn't playing, but is still having their fair share of newsworthy moments in the media. That team is the Arizona Coyotes. Now, the Coyotes have been under flak over the past few days, particularly because their 2021 first-round pick and their 2020 second-round pick got taken away from them by the league. This was because they'd conducted illegal testing on prospects in a period where no team was actually allowed to test prospects because you test prospects at the combine. The combine wasn't a thing this year, so there was no permittance for any of these NHL teams to do any form of testing for any of these prospects. Alas, after an investigation was done, it turned out that the Coyotes did indeed do stuff, which is why they got their draft picks taken away from them. But that's not it. Because when it comes to what's happening with the draft picks, we also have to take a look at what's coming after. What exactly are the consequences of this? What's going to happen because of this? And how further back this actually sets the Arizona Coyotes and their plans? First off, because this was actually mentioned a few times in the comment section of the video we made talking about the Coyotes draft picks, let's just get it straight out of the way here first. Because the Coyotes get their draft picks taken away, that means that the rounds that those draft picks are in will just be shortened by one pick each. So in 2021, the first round will have 31 teams instead of 32, because that's when Seattle is actually going to be a part of the draft. And in 2020, the second round is only going to be 30 picks long. But now that we've gotten that out of the way, let's go over to Elliotte Friedman's 31 thoughts from a few days ago. It's the same one we talked about in the previous video talking about Carolina and Freddie Anderson, but there are a lot of Arizona Coyotes related thoughts in this one here, and it starts at thought number 5, it goes on until thought number 12, and they're all some pretty long thoughts, so go ahead, click the link in the description, read this article by Friege, because there are a lot of little interesting pieces of information given out about the Arizona Coyotes situation. It starts off by talking about how they're going to be searching for a new GM because we all know that John Chayka, well, he's out. He terminated his own contract and now he is not with the team anymore. But going forward with some of these other thoughts, it talks about other layoffs within the team as well as what exactly they did that was so illegal, who did that illegal testing stuff, how Gary Bettman was treating the team after Chayka left, as well as the whole process in interviewing the necessary people to understand what illegal testing they actually did. But the interesting thought over here is thought number 7. This is the one that we will be reading over here. Take a look at this. Friedman writes that we will get to the machinations of that decision shortly. The decision he's referring to in this case is their GM search. But the penalty, which we've already discussed, means that the Coyotes don't have a pick in the top 3 rounds in 2020, and they don't have a first or third rounder in 2021. Expect the Coyotes to try to restock that, and this is where things get interesting. Even with an active goalie market, Darcy Kuemper is a guy who is a very attractive piece, thanks to his impressive playoff performance. He's signed for 2 more years at $4.5 million per. Oliver Ekman-Larsson has 7 years remaining at 8.25 mil per season, and the team would like to test his marketplace. A no-move clause gives him control, but the word around town is that he's not opposed to the idea pending the landing spot. It's not an easy contract to handle at the time, but there are other teams out there who believe Ekman-Larsson would be revitalized by a fresh start. Friedman then brings up Demers, Goligoski, Hjalmarsson, and Jordan Oesterle as guys with 1 year remaining on their contracts, and in particular how Hjalmarsson is beloved around the league. So, if we take a look at the Arizona Coyotes and their cap situation, if they want to get draft picks back, maybe moving some of their more valuable pieces is the way to do that. The fact of the matter is right here, the Coyotes were not really a good team on paper. Even heading into the 2020 Stanley Cup playoffs, they beat the Nashville Predators and ended up making the dance, but against Colorado, we really did see that the Coyotes just weren't able to match up. And when you have a team like this, with a Taylor Hall that may not even be here next year, there's a whole bunch of uncertainty as to how good this Coyotes team could be next year compared to what they did this year. And it's all the more worse when what they did this year wasn't particularly all too great. So now, because they only have one top 3 round draft pick in the next 2 years, There's certainly a lot that you need to do if you want to improve your drafting. Because when it comes to the Coyotes, you can't say that this team is in win-now mode. You're just not good enough for that. And with some pretty big contracts like Phil Kessel at $6.8 million until 2022, and Derek Stepan at $6.5 million, it's gonna be difficult to commit to a full-on, let's get rid of these big expensive guys and bring in some other young guys while keeping the other good guys we have on our team. That's where the guys who actually have value come in, because if you have an Oliver Ekman-Larsson who signed for a boatload of money for a boatload of time, you can get some value out of that. You can get some value out of Darcy Kuemper, who was really, really good in the playoffs, and you can get some value out of that. Since the Coyotes' big pieces of future for the draft got taken away, all they can do now is hope for the best as they try to restock that. And in the future, build your team around guys like Clayton Keller, Jakob Chychrun, and Nick Schmaltz, not to mention Barrett Hayton, who is also included in that as well. On the bright side, guys like Chychrun and Keller are signed for a very long time. These guys are both signed until 2025. Keller goes until 2026. So that's a long timeline that you have in being able to gather up younger guys and strengthen the youthful direction of this team as a whole. Now, I get that you don't really want to go full-on tanking, because if you go tanking, then there's really nothing to gain from that, because you don't have your first-round pick for the next two drafts. Tanking is going to be terrible for you, because there isn't going to be a reward of a guaranteed top-five draft pick. Which is kind of where the whole unfortunate aspect of this situation comes to play. Sure, I agree that they probably did deserve the punishment, but still, this team doesn't have any draft picks going into the next few years, and that is going to be so bad, since the overall direction of the team is now undefined, especially with Taylor Hall's future being in question. But if you want to take that step and further commit to building towards the future, then maybe an Oliver Ekman-Larsson's gotta go. Maybe you trade away Demers, maybe you trade away any of the other one-year remaining D-men that you have, and you commit to that future. You get some more young guys, get more prospects, get more picks, and we can see how Oliver Ekman-Larsson does when he plays on a better team that's not the Arizona Coyotes. He's the captain, I get that, but he had 30 points this season. He was on pace for about 37 over 82 games. He's reached 50 before. There's a lot to go forward here with Oliver Ekman-Larsson, and this guy is well into his prime. So I don't really know how good it would be to use up his prime on a team that just got set back another few years because they don't have any draft picks, and that just wasn't really good enough to compete in the playoffs anyway. It's a state of limbo here with Arizona, and we're going to have to see some very, very interesting decision-making going on with their new GM, whoever they get, once everything gets settled in stone. I saw a whole bunch of other people saying that they should probably trade some other guys. I saw Jakob Chychrun's name mentioned in that conversation. To me, nah, man, you build the future off of guys like Jakob Chychrun. This guy's only 22 years old. You can still have a good future with those guys once they start hitting their primes. Not to mention Dvorak and Connor Garland and all the other really nice young pieces that you have as well. And you still have Phil the Thrill, who's going to stick around on your team for a very long time, I will say that. It's unfortunate to see, especially because of how hard he dropped off. This is really not the same Phil Kessel that was the best Toronto Maple Leaf for six seasons in a row. But regardless, he's still on the team. That's a tough contract to move. So I think the likelihood that he probably finishes off that contract in Arizona is somewhat high. But as Friedman said, Oesterle is a guy, Hjalmarsson's a guy, Demers is a guy, Goligoski's a guy as well. If you get rid of one of these guys, you can play Victor Soderstrom right away. That'd be a very interesting transition. We know how good Soderstrom has been, how Chayka and his staff had him at third overall at the 2019 NHL Entry Draft. That still boggles my mind to this day. But if you believe in that guy, then bring him in. Play him in the NHL. Give him a taste of what it's like, especially if you think that he's ready. And with all this prep that they've been giving, all the hype that they've spoken about Victor Soderstrom, him actually being included on the return to play roster, there's probably an opportunity he makes the team next year, and with that in mind, it gives a lot more expendable qualities to the other D-men you have. So talk to me in the comments what you think about this whole idea. Is it time for Oliver Ekman-Larsson and for Darcy Kuemper to go? You still got Antti Raanta over there, who still does indeed have a contract. So there still is going to be some stability in net if you're looking for that angle, but Kemper's a guy that's got value. and teams are going to need goalies. So tell me in the comments what you think about this whole idea. Hope you enjoyed this edition of the Trollist and I9. And bye.